What's up, family? It's your boy, JB Trap House Boxing Man. I'm back again with another post-fight review. This here is the Kyle Williams versus Sylvester Canales post-fight review. And, you know, I'm going to make this one real sweet and simple, man, because it really wasn't too much into this fight. So I'm going to sum it up real fast for y'all, man. Shout out to the LDBC, man. Smash that like button, man. Smash that subscribe button. Always share this video. And leave your thoughts and comments after the video, man. But, anyway, let's get to it, man. Both of these guys, had a little, you know, a little awkward, herky-jerky, styles. You know, Kyle Williams, he had like a old throwback type of, stance. You know, where he kind of keeps his hands locked. He kind of like a Carl Froch type of stance. And the other kid, Sylvester Canales, you know, I think he's from Hungary. I think he's Hungarian. I believe so. But, you know, he has a herky-jerk style as well. Both of these guys are slippery, herky-jerky type of guys. And it just seems like that, you know, Kyle Williams was the bigger guy. Not saying that's the reason why he won the fight, but, you know, he just kept the pressure on Sylvester, on Canales. And Canales, it seemed like he was just in survival mode pretty much. I don't even remember him throwing too many combinations of punches like that. He was just moving around the ring, you know. Well, he would throw a little bit just to keep Kyle up off of him, but it wasn't nothing, you know, indicating that he wanted to stay in the fight. And he eventually gets stopped by a mirage of body punches throughout the whole course of the fight. I think the fight only lasted like 3 rounds. Yeah, about 3 rounds. And that was it. You know, he couldn't come out of the corner, I believe. But that was the tale of that. You know, salute to Kyle Williams. He did what he was supposed to do. And life goes on. Y'all let me know what y'all think. This your boy JB Trap House Boxing. I'm gone.